Hello, my wonderful and amazing Cliniko family. Rachel here, and as always, I'm presenting all of the news, updates, changes, and more that went down this week. Specifically, I'm discussing changes to our API, how we're now syncing payments to Xero, SMS credits, what happens when you're logged out and you attempt to interact with Cliniko, and booking with Inactive Practitioners. Let's get started with Cliniko This Week. First, we've made a number of changes to our API. Our API allows third-party companies, softwares, developers, etc. to talk with Cliniko. The big change is to the number of requests that our API can make to Cliniko. This is part of a large number of changes we've made across Cliniko to hopefully resolve the performance issues we've been experiencing. The limit essentially prevents the API from overwhelming Cliniko. Think of it as the scene from Harry Potter where the Dursleys are receiving hundreds of letters from Hogwarts requesting Harry Potter's attendance. We're essentially limiting the number of letters that can be sent at one time. That way, we don't go mad, we don't get moody, and Cliniko doesn't experience performance issues due to those letters/API requests. We're also doing more behind-the-scenes database changes to Cliniko, but API is especially important to mention. If you continue running into issues or notice some strange glitches, definitely reach out to support. Next up, if you use Xero, we've made a change to how payments are synced. If for some reason a payment was not synced to Xero, but then is later updated, we will now retry to sync with Xero. Previously, payments were only synced when initially created. Moving on, there was a way to accidentally create an appointment for an inactive practitioner. Sometimes an inactive practitioner would remain on the calendar, allowing you to accidentally create a booking. Now, if an inactive practitioner somehow remains on the calendar and you attempt to create a booking, you'll now see an error message. Speaking of error messages, when logged out of Cliniko, some browsers or devices still acted as if you were logged in, allowing you to create an appointment, archive, initiate a patient search, etc., only to be met with an error message. Now, we will redirect you to the sign-in page. That way, you can log in without running into any additional error messages. Finally, we fixed a bug that was preventing emails for SMS credit purchases from being sent. Well, that is it for this week's episode. I will be back next week for more. I also want to personally thank you all for watching and the continued support for these videos. I love you all, and until next time, goodbye!